the most incredible things. Don't forget, I fired Comey. Had I not fired Comey, you might not be talking to me right now about a beautiful book of 4 years at the White House. And we'll see about the future. The future is going to be very interesting. But I fired Comey, that whole group, and now that group is coming back again? I mean, it's not believable. It shouldn't be allowed to happen. Shouldn't be allowed to happen. I was going to say before, if I didn't fire Comey, they were looking to take down the president of the United States. If I didn't fire him, and some people said he made a mistake when he fired Comey, and now those same people said it was the most incredible instinctual moves that they've ever seen. Because I might be here with you, perhaps we'll be talking about something else. But I don't think I could have survived if I didn't fire him, because it was like a hornet's nest. When I fired him, they all went crazy against each other.
In an interview with Fox News host Mark Levin over the weekend, former President Donald Trump seemingly admitted to obstructing justice so as not to be removed from office.
Had I not fired Comey, you might not be talking to me right now. I mean, it's not believable. It shouldn't be allowed to happen. Shouldn't be allowed to happen.
As a reminder, Trump fired Comey in 2017 and acknowledged that his investigation into Russian election interference played a role. Following Comey's ouster, Special Counsel Robert Mueller, in a 2019 report, laid out 10 instances where Trump may have obstructed justice, which included Comey's ouster. But Mueller never charged Trump at the time because a sitting president can't be indicted. In addition to the Mueller report, the Senate Intel Committee report, which Republican Chair Richard Burr oversaw, also found that members of the Trump campaign worked with Russian intelligence to aid his 2016 election.
During that Oval Office meeting with senior Russian officials last week, President Trump ripping into the FBI director he'd just fired, calling James Comey crazy, a real nut job, according to the New York Times, that was read a document summarizing the meeting. Explaining the firing, Mr. Trump said, "I faced great pressure because of Russia. That's taken off." Adding, "I'm not under investigation." The conversation reinforcing suspicions that Mr. Trump's decision to fire Comey was based on the FBI's inquiry into possible collusion between the Trump campaign and Russia, a point the president hinted at with Lester last week.
When I decided to just do it, I said to myself, I said, you know, this Russia thing with Trump and Russia is a made-up story.
Trump was actually on Levin's show to promote his new book featuring photos of his time in office.
Mr. President, the book is unbelievable. It's beautiful. The pictures are beautiful.
I love our country. Part of the reason I did this book is because it is a beautiful book, and it is beautiful pictures, and it is mostly positive comments inside. I'm not ripping too many leaders of country, maybe a couple.
But what we ended up with was another example of Trump being able to shoot a person down Fifth Avenue without any consequences. There are never any consequences.
I have the most loyal people. Did you ever see that? Where I could stand in the middle of Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody and I wouldn't lose any voters, okay? It's like incredible.
Thanks for watching.